Hi there, folks, and welcome back once more to Let's Play Dark Sun Wake of the Ravager. Today, theoretically, we're going to kick the shit out of some Templars, which is always a fun time. But first, we're looking for a woman named Faina. Is that you? Hello, pedestrian. Sorry, but I'm in a hurry right now. Is this important?
Why are you in such a hurry?
I came here to visit my uncle. The news of Kallak's death gave me hope for a better life here. Right now, I'm looking for a place to live so I'm not a burden on my uncle.
Who are you?
My name is Zitka. I'm new to Tyr, but it seems a wonderful city. Perhaps I will make my stay permanent.
Have you heard any recent gossip?
I was told a woman was struck down in the streets by a bolt of magic. Don't like the sound of it. Not at all. I need to be going now. Goodbye.
Alright. Thanks for nothing, lady. Alright, so we're looking for somebody named Faina. I do not know if we have already met her. I don't really pay attention to names. My longtime viewers will know that I generally don't pay attention. I'm just here to murder hobo my way through kludgy games. Are you Faina? Can I do it from here? See, it's irksome because, like, that pedestrian, when I right clicked on her, it was like, it's a pedestrian. Whereas with this, it's just immediately conversation. So I assume you're not Faina. And there's no context-sensitive tooltips or anything like that. I wouldn't expect that out of something this age. Well, I mean, I guess the only other place we can really poke around is the merchant area. So let's slowly path over there. Wait a minute. Who are you? Are you Faina? No. Game is so clutchy. Oh my, just look at it. Like, it doesn't even know what it's doing. How do you go from Shattered Lands to this? It's so sad. Can I help you? Who are you? It's a Tinka. Traveled here from my home in the sandy waste east of Tyr for to sell my goods. There's a little opportunity for trade outside the cities.
Where do you live in the desert?
The desert has a beauty all its own, and it is more peaceful than any city I've ever visited. Besides, I'm not entirely an honor there. The Jan have accepted me as an honored guest.
Tell me about the Jan.
They're a race of genies formed out of all four elements, which I think is why they are masters of art. It was they who taught me to weave. It is their adherence to strict codes of honor and respect which attracts me, so different than the harsh people one usually encounters.
How do I find the Jan?
You would need to take a caravan. The caravan master at the main gate can tell you when the next one is leaving.
That's probably good information. I should be like writing this shit down. Where's notepad? I'm gonna start writing things down. Caravan master in Tyr can tell us when the next caravan to the Jan is heading out. Video games. Okay. Who are you? Are you who I'm looking for?
Day, can I interest you in buying something?
Sure. What you got? Arrows. 12 plus 1 arrows. You know what? I'm gonna buy one of these grappling hooks. It would not surprise. It's why I bought this crowbar. It would not surprise me if there's some use case for that at some point.
Thank you for your business.
Because these games do like their bullshit. I even remember in Shattered Lands there were a few points where rope was useful. Who are you?
Good day to you, sir. Are you interested in buying anything?
What you got? More magic arrows. Are these plus one arrows? They are. It's the exact same store.
Have you heard any rumors?
All of Tyr talking about the assassination at the main gate. But you would know more about that than a simple merchant like myself, eh? Be sure to come back if you ever need something. Goodbye.
All right. So this woman. It's not like there's a ton of NPCs in this town. You? Yeah, sure. Show me what you got. Bone ring mail, some leather, a shield, some booties. Bone ring. Other bracer, a helm. Does the helmet do anything? No. All right. No fucks given. See, what is she using? Bone Brigandine? It's about the same as Bone Ring. Can she use this? Yes, she can. There we go. AC bonus. Metal Chain. Can she? Yes, she can. Rove, you get nothing because you suck. All right. The music. The music just going mute kills me because there's like no background audio in this fucking game. It's terrible.
What do I have in here? Looks like a bunch of stupid assholes picked a fight and lost.
I don't think you're who I'm looking for. No, you're Boric with your fancy magical sword and Dark Sun, which is fucking priceless treasure. No path. Motherfucker. They can't walk out a door. You can't path around the corner. Oh my god. This is gonna be a game, isn't it? This is gonna be a game that I'm just going to be reeing about this entire time. Gird yourselves. I don't suppose was... Fayina wasn't the proprietress of the inn, was she? I'll be a salty motherfucker. Well, not really, because we got some gear upgrades. Oh, we bought gold leaf some armor. What is this pathing? What is this? Why? Why? What algorithm are you guys using? Oh my god. I want to ask you a few questions.
What do you know about the Veiled Alliance?
The only thing I can't tell if this, I think this is a woman. The only thing I know about these sorcerers is that I don't want to know anything. People have a tendency of turning up dead after getting involved with them.
Why do they turn up dead?
People say, kill a sorcerer and you save a piece of life. Then there's the Defilers and Templar. They have their own reason for wanting other magic users dead.
And what do you know about the miners?
They live a harsh life and a life that usually lasts about a week. Then if they do survive, the mine foreman takes all their profit.
Tell me about your inn.
Harbinger's Roost has a distinguished history befitting its high standards of quality.
Do you have any other guests here?
It's a very popular inn, if I do say so myself. Guests are in and out all the time. In fact, a woman named Fayina just checked in the other day. Okay, she's in the room next door.
What do you know about her?
We're grilling this lady. I don't like asking my customers too many questions. You understand. But I have seen her about town quite a bit lately, and not in the best of company. You don't want to watch your purse around that one. All right. Yes, find this woman named Fayina. She's next door, but I'm not going to tell you that because I'm a... Oh, wait, no. The dwarf wasn't in here. Never mind. No, our nappy time was in here. All right, lady, give me all your money. Oh, come right in. Don't mind the door being shut. Okay, I respect this. Having NPCs call player characters on their bullshit in video games when they just, like, wander into houses.
Thanks, but no. Don't get cheeky. I didn't mean to...
You do what? Oops, wrong room.
I didn't mean to intrude.
Oh, you're good walking through a closed door at an inn and apologizing. I almost believe you.
Who are you?
Name's Fayina. I've been working here for about 6 months now. It's a rich town despite its troubles.
Arslan said you regularly robbed the Templars.
You did, huh? I'll have to talk to him about being so free with my name. It's true, though. It's like stealing from a blind man. Now the Templars have no power.
Can you help me get into the offices?
Your eagerness shows you've got grit, but before I can do anything, I have a problem with a car, the merchant. If you take care of my problem, I'll tell you how to go into the Templar's offices. You'll be able to come and go as you please, with no one the wiser. Deal?
What's your problem with a car?
It's really more of a misunderstanding. Seems I caused him a minor discomfort when a Templar he had bribed turned up dead. He wants me to pay off the kickbacks he would have received from the Templar, some 10,000 ceramics. You can convince him to forget the debt or pay him off. I'll tell you how to get into the Templar's offices.
All right, where is he?
It's in his mansion on the northwest side of town.
It's a deal.
You're a lifesaver. You're a lifesaver. I'll wait here while you go talk to a car. Wasn't a car the guy with the plus one sword? I like magic weapons, you guys. I really like magic weapons, and he is alone in that house. Wait, no, was he a car? Or was a car the guy with the... Ow. Was a car the guy with the magic portrait? I think a car might have actually been the guy with the magic portrait. Look at that pathfinding go, that cloak waggle. It's got... He's, like, sauntering. I love it. He's got a sassy walk on him. As well as the Sass Master 9000 over here. Yeah, because I think this was a car, wasn't it? Hey, car, where's your butler? Doesn't look like he's around. It would be a shame if you were to be attacked in your own home. Are you a car? Yes, you are. Oh, you've only got a longsword, and you're only level 3. Alright, let's see how... It's so fucking jank that you can just, like, walk through NPCs. That is so fucking bad. Alright, buddy. Let's see if we can do this without me murdering you. Ah, hello, sir. It's always a pleasure to see you. I'm here to talk to you about Fiena. Ah, Fiena. Now, there's a woman with a fine sense of value. It's too bad her dislike of Templar gets in the way of good sense. As I recall, she owes me quite a sum of money.
Maybe you could just forget the debt.
I run a business, not a charity.
I'm here to pay off the debt she owes you.
It's very noble of you, and I've certainly no objection to you paying. The debt was 10,000 ceramic pieces, I recall. Will you pay?
No!
Perhaps I misunderstood, but you said you wanted to clear her debt.
Surely the money is not of prime interest.
That's more important than money. This is a chance to get an even higher profit. Perhaps we could make a deal between ourselves.
Yes, I could let you live.
You may threaten all you like, but if I gave in to you, how long do you think I'd live? A merchant who can be intimidated becomes the target of every hoodlum in town. Talk to me again after you've decided to be sensible.
My sense is murder! Problem solved.
Ooh. These like totally are magical robes. Yoink. Metal chain armor and a metal longsword. Man, so many NPCs in this town are just having fatal accidents. Uh-oh. Hi, guys. Is it just the two of you? 3, 4. Man, you need more dudes. I'm sorry to say. I was expecting him to call guards if we threatened to kill him. So I'm not surprised that we're getting into a fight here. Oh, the spell effects are so jank. It's just markedly worse than the first game in every way. Chunk, do violence. I hope we're still buffed. Yes, we are. Get him, Gold Leaf. All right. So I'll go out here and beat the shit out of this dude so that we stay in combat.
So I heard you liked melee damage. I'm a gladiator with 8 attacks around and a vampiric doom blade that I'm pretty sure eats the souls of those I smack around with it. Good shit.
This is Swell's villain arc. Alright, well, I mean, there's the guards down. That wasn't anything too particularly troublesome. Alright. I'm not gonna save until after we talk to her again, just in case the game's like, you fucking dunce, why would you kill the man? He was, I don't know, a merchant lord or some shit. I don't know. I'm not here for the writing, I'm here for the turn-based combat and violence. And the incredibly low frame rate for a game with so little going on. Apparently we're running this thing on an emulated 480 or something. I don't know, it's just so fucking slow. They reprogrammed the entire game engine in Fortran because they could. Alright, your dude problem is solved, lady. Have you talked to a car yet?
He's dead, I killed him.
You did what? Just made a serious mistake. There's nothing but death waiting for me in Tyr. Now I'll have to find another town where I can hide from his family now. Thanks. Oh, can I kill you too? I totally can. You can just kill everybody in this. Oh, now the camping area is gone.
Just give us a moment in here with the body. We have to loot it properly.
Oh my god, that frame rate is just murder on me. Kindly leave the inn and not come back. I don't allow my guests to go around killing each other. Yes,
yes, we're going. Oh, hey, look. Thieves.
It hit for one. Wow. I have no intention of continuing this. We're going to be reloading. Don't worry. But first, I have to take care of the one mouthing off over here. My god, that innkeeper's dynamite impervious. All right, let's just load. And this is why you save before you go on a killing spree. I'm just gonna pay the guy. He seems like a trash panda, so I'm not gonna. No, that's unfair to trash pandas. Raccoons are cool. This guy seems kind of like a bit of a shitheel. All right, I'm here to pay off the debt. Yes. Sure, I like experience points. Thank you, and you can tell Faina that she no longer has to worry about any threats I may have made. All right. Free experience. I wonder if we kill him if we can get our money back. We're just like, burgle it out of his house or something. I don't know. How is it that this game can show so much less and run so much more poorly than Shattered Lands? It makes me so sad. Shattered Lands was such a good game. And this is, it's trying. I can't bitch too much. My biggest issue is the performance is just real bad. But no, I have to give him props that she bitched at us when we came in here, and after we murdered her and went to leave, the inn proprietor told us to fuck off. That's some nice cause and effect there. I wasn't expecting that. You no longer owe a car anything. Wow, another 5,000 XP.
Arslan was right about you, Swell, saying you're something different from the average adventurers who just out for loot. I owe you a great deal, thanks.
It's not so much that we're different, we just came into this game with like 150,000 ceramics and there's nothing worth buying.
In order to get into the Templar offices, you must know the correct knock. If you knock twice, and then once, the door will open for you. Oh, and here's a key to the back door of the offices. It'll only work on the door to the storeroom on the east side, but I found that Templars often leave valuables in there. Alright, I'm gonna write down really quickly. Knock twice, and then once to get into Templar offices, because otherwise I'm gonna forget.
What do you know about the Templar?
I know enough about the Templars to realize they're the scum of Athas. There isn't a thing crawling that's more repulsive. You don't like them very much. Really? I would have never guessed.
Really? Airport noises? It's fucking 2:40 in the morning. Good God. Go to bed, airport. It's time.
Do you know what they're planning to do?
They want to get their power back, and they'll do whatever it takes to ensure they get it.
Are they using defiler?
Well, yes, of course they're using defiler magic.
Wouldn't surprise me, but I haven't seen any evidence of them using defiler magic. It's probably just a rumor to get people's anger stirred against them, as if they aren't hated enough already.
What have you seen them doing?
What strikes me is that after the sorcerer king was killed, a lot of the Templars left Tyr. Now I'm seeing new Templars arrive, and these Templars aren't like the others I know.
Alright. Well, thanks for not expanding on that at all, but okay. Let's get in there and do some violence on some people that actually probably deserve having violence done upon them. See if we can find that other guy's brother. Game's like, man, you got more than one moving thing on the screen at 2 frames per second. I'm sorry, I'm gonna be bitching about it for the entirety of this Let's Play. I can already hear the whinging in the comments.
Okay, I'm getting the music going again.
All right, use the door. Knock twice, then once. Oh, that's nice. They give you the correct combination only if you've talked to her. Otherwise, it's just random bullshit. Man, I love it when games do shit like that, actually. Okay, so we've got dudes. Those look like just some mules lurking around. We have a random guy. No path. Looks like there's a door right... okay.
Get away from that door. Only government officials are allowed there. Sorry, I didn't know. But of course, we are all on the same side now, right?
Okay, so there's apparently a door there.
So I'm sure that when we inevitably start bullshitting here, these mules are gonna go hostile. Let's just close the door. Hey, friends. Tyrian soldiers, level 8. If this were any game but Dark Sun, I would be like, wow, that's pretty ridiculous for just random guards standing around. Voices are seeping out of the next room through a small hole in the wall. You hear a woman say loudly,
"Unwise to underestimate our power. We still control all that happens in Tyr."
A man says, "And that is why we seek an alliance. When the dragon comes to Tyr, he will of course demand total control of the city." Another man agrees, "If there is the slightest resistance, he will be displeased. And the Lord Warrior..." The voice fades out of hearing.
I didn't even know there was a hole, I was just interested in the chest. A scroll with what appears to be personal notes. What is this? Robes.
I think I see what they're doing. Like, this is the head, like, the hole where your head would come out, and these are just the sleeves, but man, those look janky. And oh my god, it's a wizard's hat. We're taking that. That's going to Rove. And a ring. And some coins. Fruit with protection from lightning and fruit with bless. I honestly don't care about either of those. We do, however. Where's that fancy robe that I ganked? Oh, wait, no, we didn't kill him. Never mind. Rove, put on your wizard hat. Okay, so what's on this scroll? Scroll of the Draxon High Templar Smid, entitled Priorities. Man, all these people have such jank names. Open it. First, the Lord Warrior's business with the Jan. Second, using the Tyrian Templars to neutralize the Veiled Alliance. And thirdly, preparing the place of welcome arrival for the Dragon of Erdraxa. Oh boy. What is this?
That's the one that we started with. Okay. Let's go ahead and save again. You guys just stay down there and be chill.
Alright, so we heard two male voices and a female voice, but there's only two NPCs in here. I don't know about you guys.
Touch that door again and you die.
Alright, I'm touching it again.
Spies, kill them!
Chunk, violence. God. The damage sounds. Oh, there's the third one. They're trying. Okay, Gold Leaf, you're not gonna be able to cast because you got beat on, aren't you? Yeah. Can't do psionics. Do you have any magic items worth using? Not really. All right, flailing ineffectually at that man. Good job. A for effort. I should have picked this fight. Oh, and of course you come in and smack Rove, you fucker. Ooh, petulant rage. What does this rod do? Wasn't this like dismissal? Yeah. This will probably be useful later in the game when they start throwing demons and shit at us, assuming that they do. Yeah, that's our burning hands knife. Man, I miss having like wands and shit. Anything that isn't just that. It'd be great if my melees could actually act. But apparently Swell just rolled the worst initiative ever. Actually, I think I'm gonna reload. I don't wanna quit. It rustles my Jimmy something fierce that escape doesn't open this menu, that it's tab to open this menu. It just is wholly senseless to me. Okay. Let's see, where would be a good guy? Good place to fight these guys. I basically want somewhere. I think these doors are 3 tall. Good God. All right. So I come up here. OK,
Okay, I do this. Open the party up. Rove, I hate you. All right, cast haste. Okay, nope. One, save. Okay, no, not Rove, Swell. Wow. Level, oh, I just realized these dudes are level 15. Okay. All right, they're making me work for it. Fair enough. All right, I'm gonna, oh my God. Struggle to move the camera and cast a stinking cloud down here. Maybe hold people off a little bit. Kindly die. Thank you, sir. Okay, good loot on you. Yoink. Yoink. Plus one mace. All right. What do you got on? Bone armor. Bone armor. Bone armor. Okay. So I'll end your turn. I honestly do not. Ah, here we go. Guard. Sorry. Walk into the fart cloud.
Walk into the fart cloud and die.
And you can just come here and guard. My hope is that a bunch of them get stuck in this thing. And then I'm just gonna throw fireballs in there. Can I do... may reduce the movement rate. I wonder if this'll stack. Oh, it's like a wall. So now if I right click because I didn't know this was a wall, it's gonna cancel the spell, which is just the biggest crock of bullshit. So we'll just kind of approximate. So bad. That's right, I was ready for you, you shit. I'm ready for you too. Oh, he's too slow. Oh, I don't know what that is, but I do not like, oh, he has no attacks. You can see, oh, well, he had no attacks. Now he's getting chunked. I do know that one of these guys has the blue pants. All right, two of these guys have. Oh, Tyrian soldiers. All right, it's Tyrian soldiers versus Draxons. The difference? No idea. Is it in the manual? Probably not. I don't think these are new enemies. Because this game's only got like two new enemies in it. And it's like classic manual, so there's actually like a bestiary in it, which is just one of my favorite things from old games that you just don't get anymore. All right, there's no notes in here about these, and the only new enemies are something called a Kartang, a Soul Shard, and a Verini. Although apparently this game has a Rumvaraxes in it, which are pretty nasty, or they can be nasty. 1-4 attacks, plus 1 per 2 levels. What level is Rove? I think he's like 9? He's 11th level, okay, Jesus. I didn't realize we had that many levels under our belt. Let's see. Web's probably a bit much. I just fireball. I mean, when in doubt, carefully fireball. Ooh. I'm sorry, Swelling Goldleaf, maybe. Oh no, okay. So it didn't actually hit everyone it said it was going to hit. Tank, Chunk, tank! You have to hold the line. That's right, just strafe back and forth on the Spike Grove. It appears that Stinking Cloud is doing nothing, which is very disappointing. Chunk is going to go down. He's got to be fucking one hit point. Yeah, that's what I figured. I mean, I'd heal him, but this is like, yeah, like a point, like one hit. If the use to injure, the target is stunned. How do I do that? He's like, does it not allow a save if I use it to injure? Because that could be pretty good. Are you stunned? Paralyzed. Chunk. Yeah, get those sneak attacks going, boy. They beat the shit out of him, and then Chunk's like, my turn. Kalau Buta. Oh, Chunk. Chunk is probably dead. That's 24 damage. Yeah. And of course, I don't think... Yeah, we cannot raise... I think Chunk is just like Ripperoni right now. Negative 1 AC. They are missing him, or they are hitting him like all the time, but no one has touched Swell yet. My petulance knows no bounds. No, I want to load game. That's right, save mid-combat with half your party dead. I mean, I guess I could pre-battlefield control a little bit. Come in here, cast haste, start throwing stinking clouds around, and the Templar are just like, oh, it's just what they do. Those silly adventurers. Just doing adventure things as you do. Okay, now gold leaf. What? Look at this, a fourth level spell conjures a rope of thorns that does 1-4 points of damage on a failed saving throw. That is so unbelievably bad. That's like a cantrip. Oh my god. How big an AoE is quicksand? Let's do this. Oh yeah, oh yeah. That's what Pappy Ghost likes to see. All right, Chunk. No, you guys stay out of it. It's a shame, I was hoping those would be sneak attacks. Damn it. Good damage. All right, gold leaf. Oh, I was gonna conjure a water elemental. That's okay. Do I have Dust Devil? No, we're not an air. Never mind, ignore me. They don't have any spellcasters, which I am incredibly thankful for. But, alright, I guess we'll just prayer. Rove, just get out of there, buddy. Oh no, Rove, what are you doing? You just stay right where you are, buddy. Don't fucking do that again. Nope. Where was it? I want you to... No. Man. Here's some disappointing fireballs, I gotta say. And not just because the frame rate makes them borderline unusable. Alright, good talk. Sorry, walk into the quicksand. Yeah! Enjoy your can't move. Y'all better believe we're gonna be saturating that area with death magic as soon as I can get line of sight. What are those arrows? I am so worried that those are something horrible. We have ranged. I mean, yeah, but no. This fight's gonna last forever. Although I expect some guys are probably gonna come in through that southern passage there. Oh, there's a note on the ground. All right, Rove. No, where was it? That looks like a much more productive... Get that group down bottom. Oh, there we go. Now that is a fireball. 42 damage. That 9, though. Very disappointing, Rove. Very disappointing. I gotta say, quicksand thus far. Pretty MVP. Doing some real damn good work. Good job, Chunk. A plus. Swell. Hold the line. Yeah, quicksand. Quicksand kind of the goat here. It's gonna start sucking though momentarily because we're almost out of AoE spells. Summon insects. Here you go, buddy. Have some bugs.
Quit arrowing my cleric, you fucks. The only downside with the quicksand is that, like, the melees can't go out there. So that's kind of a pain in the ass, but we can try for a hold person. Where is it? Come on. There we go. You're fucked, buddy. Oh. God. That thief damage multiplier on helpless targets is just so good. So good. I should have had Swell guard and just wait for these guys instead of attacking them. Oh shit, there are spellcasters. That's like entangle. This fight is going to last forever and we're already at like, what, 36 minutes? Oh no. All right, we still have fireballs though, which is okay by me. I didn't even see that one guy that we got. Nice. Which one to use, a spell thrower? Or are they both? Oh, you walked right into Chunk. Was it you? No line of sight. Because I know one of them's Draxon. Or no, they're not. What are these guys? Are these just the Templar? I think one of them had a name, and that mildly horrifies me. No. Here we go. Here we go. Ah, I got two of them. I'll take it. Rove, just get as far back in that corner as you can, buddy. We have Ice Storm. But I think Rove is mostly out of, well, no, Magic Missile's pretty good. Wait, is that Solid Fog? Locks line of sight. I'm just gonna enlarge Chunk. Fucking 59 damage, what is that? Get him, Chunk. Oh, 63! My god! Chunk, what? 2 times 1d4 plus 11, 2 times 1d8 plus 10. Oh my god! So that's like 22 to, god, what is it, 18 to 36 damage with a longsword, except apparently he was sneak attacking that guy because he nailed him for 60. Well, now we know enlarge is real good, and I'm arrowing this guy so he can't cast any more spells at us. We like edge our way in the melee range with these guys. No, we cannot. Stinking Cloud is too potent. All right, in that case, we'll just guard. Yeah, because these guys, we're not gonna be able to fight them at all because of Stinking Cloud. Do we have Flaming Sphere, actually? No, we don't. We have Web, Glitter Dust, Fog Cloud, a Wall of Fog, okay. It's all that line of sight block. Fucking Ice Storm. God damn it. I don't want to cast Ice Storm. It's so garbage for what it is. Yes, you can cast... No. You can cast Fireball for 11d6. Or you can cast Ice Storm for 3d10. It's D10s, so it's more, but it's really not, because fuck you. Keep pouring ranged attacks onto this guy. I just want to keep him from casting. I don't really care about actually hurting him. All right, these guys are also, well, you're enlarged. Are you going to just do like, no. Here, I want to have you come up here and guard. Lord Humongous can sit there and wait. Oh, you walked into Swell, you fool. I gotta give him props for the combat. Like, this fight has required tactics, and it's nice to have to do things like this where we get to play cheesy bullshit from the beginning of the game. Oof. Instead of like in Shattered Lands, where it wasn't until basically the end of the game where they started making you kind of work for stuff.
I don't want to hold any of these guys because they're so far out and it'll be a pain in the ass to go get them. The curses are melee, cause blindness. Is this melee arranged? That's melee. It'd be nice if they would tell us the range on these spells in the spell descriptions, just for the sake of convenience. We could dehydrate. Lungs of water. Drowning if they are not able to cough the stuff up. Like, lose one con per round. So yeah, this fight's gonna last for like, you know, cause this is Dark Sun, this is Athas. This fight's gonna last 18 rounds. Yeah, we could kill him with that. Let's try dehydrate. Oh, is it also a melee range? Good God. So bad. So bad. Where's Bless? Here, I'll just cast Bless. Because why not, I guess. Thanks for that stock sound effect, game. I appreciate you. We'll do another Ice Storm. Well, can I do this without killing Chunk? I don't think so. Well, without killing Chunk, just hit some other guys. Those were good damage rolls. There's a 30 in there. That's right, enlarged arrows. Size of a small truck. Swell is just itching to get in and turn this guy's face into pudding. Rover, are you gonna steal that kill with a magic missile? Do it. Do it! Oh, you tried. What is that? Oh, a corpse. It's like, what can I shoot that's on the ground there? Okay, just put arrows into this dude. He ain't moving. We'll save spells. There we go. Alright, everybody get out of the hell stuff. I'm gonna save again. Let's lose some bodies. No. Cake. There we go. Mace. Might give that to Gold Leaf, actually. Ooh. Is that Pebbles the Boulders? Ooh! Yes! That's a good one. I think that's like a fourth level spell, though. Bone Scale Armor. Hell yeah. +2 Toothed Club. With Shocking Grasp on it. That's going to Gold Leaf. A Fruit of Removed Fear. Some Bone Armor, some Bone Armor. All right, they're giving us goodies too, which I'm thankful for. Two-handed Bone Polearm. Don't really care about the arrows. Okay, I know. It'd be nice if all this crap would go away so I could see the ground. I assume these are metal axes, yeah. These soldiers were very well equipped for Athasian soldiers. Like metal equipment is super rare in Athas. Alright, let's walk through the fart clouds and the evil floor. Seriously, I know. Give me. Ooh, I fucking love these little animated sprites. I loved them in the first game. I love them here. I cannot get enough. It's just such a small, simple thing, and it brings me so much joy. Did I loot you? I did not. All right, let's take a look at this gear. Okay, we have a key. We switch to Swell. Nope. There we go. Second box. Keys. Oh, L's drinker. One day. What is this? Just a 1,000 gold piece gem. We're gonna put documents in here. This club is going to Gold Leaf. What is she using now? A +1 axe. God, this thing is nuts. This is a, like, nasty weapon. Can she actually use this sword? No. That's Why can she use an axe? Oh, she actually can't use the axe. It was just apparently letting her momentary video game, whatever. I'm gonna give her this bone mace as well. Just as kind of a fallback. But this armor, AC 2, AC 4, AC 2, AC 2. So we actually don't need this. I was hoping that would be an upgrade for somebody. All right. So this is the goal over here. Oh my god. I'm gonna save. I wanna try memorizing this spell and hopefully I don't accidentally cast it. I do this. You learn the spell. See, I think this is like a fourth level. Yeah. 11 to 26 damage. That's actually a better spell than Ice Storm, but the problem is that this does not allow a saving throw. Whereas I'm pretty sure Pebble the Boulder requires an attack roll. Rove being Rove isn't going to be too particularly good at those, but hey, it's another spell, so that's a win. On that note, though, I do think I'm going to go ahead and call it. We have gone a good bit over time, so as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time, and I will see you all next time. We're in note. Until then! Hey, you made it to the end. Nice. If you had a good time, check out one of these other series, see if you like them. Drop a like, comment, or subscribe if you'd like to support the channel, via the machine and all that. As always, thanks for watching!